नमस्ते चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ आवर चैप्टर दैट इज कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड. सो इन दिस कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड, इन आवर अर्लियर क्लासेस वी केम टू नो द वर्ड दैट इज न्यूट्रिएंट एंड द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स दैट इज योर मैक्रो एंड माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट्स दैट आर प्रेजेंट इन आवर बॉडी. Where the macronutrients are your energy giving nutrients like your carbohydrates and fats. Another macronutrient that is your proteins, which is helpful in the growth and development. When it comes to your micronutrients, which we are calling them as a protective foods, which are helping us to fight with the diseases, that is your vitamins and minerals. And even water and roughages, that is your dietary fibers, which are playing a vital role in the proper growth and development of our body. So we are calling these also as a nutrients. Even though they are required in a minute quantities, they are helpful in development and proper growth of our body. So now in our today's class, we are going to learn what are protective foods and how the protective foods are helpful to our body. So generally, whenever you are falling ill, these vitamins, they will help us to protect from the illness and to fight with the diseases that are causing to our body. Such a vitamins, if you will observe, there are two different types of vitamins that we will notice. One such vitamins we are saying as a fat soluble vitamins, and the second category, it is your water soluble vitamins. So based on the solubility, in which type of solvent they are getting dissolved, we have classified the vitamins into two different categories. One is fat soluble vitamins and the second one is water soluble vitamins. So your fat soluble vitamins are vitamin A, D, E, and K. And your water soluble vitamins are vitamin B complex and C. So based on the solubility, in which type of solvent they are getting dissolved, so we have classified the vitamins into two different groups. One is your fat soluble, where your vitamin A, D, E, and K will come. And the second one is water soluble vitamins, where your vitamins like B complex and C will come. So let us first learn about fat soluble vitamins. The one best example of your fat soluble vitamins, that is vitamin A. So vitamin A, generally it's called your retinol. It is one such vitamin which is very much important for a proper vision. And this vitamin A, richly available in food sources like your carrot, leafy vegetables, egg yolk, all those things. As I said, this is present, it's helpful for a good vision. And if you are intaking vitamin A deficiency food, then we are going to suffer with eyesight problems. Like one such problem, it is your night blindness. A person is unable to see in the dim light. And another such type of vitamin A deficiency disease, it's called your xerophthalmia. Another such vitamin deficiency disease, it is called your xerophthalmia, where due to lack of water in the eyes will completely become dry, and it leads to blast of the eyeball, where a person will completely loses his eyesight. So these are some of the vitamin A deficiency foods, that is your night blindness and xerophthalmia. Remember, vitamin A, it is richly available in the food sources like your carrot, leafy vegetables, egg yolk, and etc. And it's very much important to give a proper eyesight to our body. And now the second type of fat soluble vitamin, that is your vitamin D. Vitamin D, it is called with a scientific name, that's called calciferol, because this is very much important for the calcium ions to fix in the body. So now this vitamin A, it is available in fish oils and even the early rays of the sunlight. Okay, so if any person who is suffering with this vitamin D deficiency, they are going to face a problem that is called your rickets. As I said, it is a calciferol and helpful to fix the calcium ions in the body. This vitamin A, it is helpful to strengthen the bones, to formation of the bones, strengthen the bones and even teeth, because these are the two areas where the calcium ions are very much important. Yes, so now if a person is suffering with the deficiency of this vitamin D, that time he is going to suffer with a condition called your rickets, where the bones of the person are becoming soft and they will bend. So during this rickets condition, either we will observe a bow legs, means a bended legs like this, or we even notice a condition that is knock knees. When a person, he is walking, both the knees, they will knock with each other. So these are the two conditions that we'll notice in the rickets case, where due to the improper formation of bones and softening of the bones will become totally bent and they are going to suffer with this condition of bow legs and knock knees. So skeletal system is one such system which gives a perfect framework to our body. So during this formation and strengthening of the skeletal system, if you are not taking a nutritious food, then this will become a lifelong problem. So vitamin D is one such vitamin which contains the calcium ions and strengthens the bones. So it's very much important to take the vitamin D rich food during the age of development. So fish oil, sunlight, milk, these are some good sources of your vitamin D. Another such vitamin, that is your vitamin E, one more fat soluble vitamin, that is your vitamin E. This is scientifically called as tocopherol. Scientifically, your vitamin E, it's called your tocopherol, which is generally seen in foods like your leafy vegetables, tomatoes, all those things, which is very much helpful for us to keep our body fit and for a good glow on the skin. Along with this, your tocopherol is one such vitamin that is playing a vital role in the reproduction. So the reproductive organs, they are secreting the reproductive cells called gametes. Vitamin E is very much important in the gametic production. If any person is unable to produce the gametes, then we are calling that condition as a sterile condition. And the one who is suffering with the sterile condition, if he will take the vitamin E rich food, which is acting as an anti-sterile vitamin. Anti-sterile means opposite to the sterility. It will improve the gametic production in the persons and acts against the sterility. So vitamin E, even it is called your anti-sterile vitamin, which is generally, scientifically, it's called your tocopherol. Along with the fitness in our body and good glow to our skin, it's mainly helping in the gametic production in our human. So it's very much important to intake even a vitamin E rich food from the age of adolescence. So green leafy vegetables, tomatoes are one such good sources of your vitamin E. So now the last vitamin in the fat soluble vitamins category, that is your vitamin K. Vitamin K, it is richly seen in the food materials like your cabbages, tomatoes, means especially it is seen in all the different variety of vegetables, which is very, very, very important as it is one of the blood clotting factors and helps in the clotting of blood. So in your lower classes, you came to know that whenever you have an injury, Platelets are the specialized blood cells that are coming and acting on the site of injury and helps in the clotting of the blood. So along with the platelets, there are some different blood clotting factors are present which are helping in the clotting of the blood. Vitamin K is one such factor that helps in the clotting of the blood. So intake of this vitamin K rich food is one of the good thing that it helps and fastens the clotting of the blood and prevents the much more loss of blood from the injured area. So today in our class we came to know what are the different types of vitamins, and we completed fat soluble vitamins. So in our next class we are going to come across the different water soluble vitamins, that is your vitamin B and vitamin C, and the deficiency diseases that are caused by your vitamin B and C.